is your First Alert 5 weather with Alex O'Brien.
Good Sunday morning. It's now 7:13, and any lingering precipitation is really starting to evaporate and dissipate this morning. Still some light snowfall in the mountains north of us, and in the San Juans, a couple batches of snow still possible. But most of the rain in the plains has now quit, and any of those wet roadways will start to dry up. But those of us who have seen more snow, like Monarch Mountain overnight, definitely rejoicing, because Monarch has not seen much snow at all, and a lot of the snow they have seen has melted. Monarch Mountain naturally has their snow. They don't really have any snow makers, so this is good news to hopefully kickstart their ski season. They're still not open yet. Now, the winds have been very strong with this storm system. In the past 3 to 4 hours, this is where we've seen these maximum wind gusts up to 74 miles per hour. Walsenburg, Wetmore up to 68 miles per hour. Honey, Alamosa, 66 miles per hour is the top wind gust reported there. Crestola, 65. Colorado City, 64. Swissvale Air Force Academy, 61 miles per hour. Keep in mind, the minimum wind speed for a severe thunderstorm warning is 58. Miles per hour. So it's definitely severe enough outside for those high wind warnings. Now, across the region, when you see more of these brown hues, that's where we still are seeing wind gusts over 50 miles per hour. Right now, Woodland Park reporting a 60 mile per hour wind gust and near 60 miles per hour in Rye. So we're still breezy to start the day. Our high wind warning is in effect until 8 a.m. Expect those winds to gradually diminish after that. So here's how those winds will look in Colorado Springs and Pueblo today. They'll gradually decrease, but stay pretty gusty throughout the rest of this afternoon. We will have sunshine in place and our temperatures will be much cooler. So here's our storm system that moved through overnight. What we're watching is this next cold front that will impact us as soon as tonight and into Monday. And that will provide us with a reinforcement of cooler air, plus another batch of snow possible for some spots. So today we're going to stay dry through the rest of the afternoon in the plains. Could still pick up on a stray shower this evening in Fremont County. And our mountains in general, along the continental divide here, the collegiate peaks likely to get more snow come late tonight. These snow showers will move further east through the daytime on Monday. And I do expect at least some snow flurries in the Pikes Peak region along I-25 and for the southern I-25 corridor. But it's not going to accumulate. We might just have some clouds and a few light flurries here and there. I expect minimal impacts from that snow in low elevations. But on the mountain peaks, we do expect to see a couple more inches of snow through Monday. Temperature-wise, today we are a lot cooler, but we're closer to where we should be this time of year. I've got 50s and 60s for most of the plains, 40s and 50s into the mountains. By tonight, we'll be below freezing for many spots, or in the upper 30s. And then by tomorrow, I've got 30s and 40s in the mountains, 40s and 50s in the lower terrain. So we're reinforcing that cold air with this next cold front, and it's gonna stick around. The mid 40s are what we expect for Colorado Springs next week, with 20s overnight. For Pueblo, 60s today, and then 50s for the rest of next week. I have taken off your precipitation chance Monday, and in fact, for most of our other regions, I only have an impact 1 out of 5. The snow Monday will be very light, few and far between those flakes. For Canyon City, you'll be in the 40s and 50s next week. Woodland Park, 40s and 30s as that cold air really settles in with teens overnight.